Well done.
We're encouraging you right now to trot over to the kitchen if you want to join us for a very, very tasty treat this Thanksgiving season.
Exactly. Well, folks, we've been doing this for many, many years. We've been creating Lou's Mom Stuffing. Back after my mom passed away in 1989. I'll just show you my mom. Her name is Sandy. Sandy Seipolt. And there's Big Lou there back in the day. I think I was at my sister's wedding there. But again, absolutely amazing woman, and after her passing we shared this recipe with people, and people have been using it ever since, and it's an honor to be able to share her recipe with everybody here today. Taylor, you have never had this before.
No, I haven't.
Maybe we should let this guy
create. Let him do the cooking.
He can do the cooking. So Taylor is going to be doing the cooking here this morning.
Okay, here we go.
All right, it's very simple. Let's take a look and let you know what you're going to need here, folks. So we'll step by step through here. These are the items that you're going to have to run out to the store and get. And here's the cool thing about it, Jackie. Between two of the biggest grocery stores in town, everything is on sale. If you go back and forth, you'll be able to get everything on sale now.
Nice.
It's important that you look for Pepperidge Farms or Brown's Berry herb seasoned cubes, not the regular ones, the cubes to give it a little body to it.
Okay.
Uncle Ben's long grain wild rice, the original, not the quick cook.
Okay.
And then a couple of cans of chicken broth. All three of those things are on sale. Water chestnuts, even those are on sale. Sage, a pork sausage, Jimmy Dean is the brand, is on sale at one of the grocery stores right now. Eggs, onions, celery, and celery's 49 cents at one of the grocery stores.
Perfect. Right now,
a clove of garlic, stick of butter, and then a little bit of pepper. So those are the things that you need.
Perfect.
So here's what we need to do. It's step by step. It doesn't take that long, but once you make it, people are going to love it. Okay,
excellent.
Taylor? So first thing you need to do, the thing is most time consuming, is cooking the wild rice. So we've already done that for you.
Okay, good.
So Taylor went and cooked this
earlier
today.
Magic of television.
So here's the wild rice. It is already cooked. So we're going to take that and we're going to set that aside for the time being.
Okay.
Now once you get done, you take that there. So once we get done with the wild rice, now we're going to do the croutons. Now the croutons are
croutons.
Okay, there's the Brownsberry. Here is the Pepperidge Farms.
Got
this
it.
Is what they look like. Now go ahead and put a whole bag.
Here, I'll let you get in the
bag.
Middle there. So
in
you
a big
can,
old bowl here.
Okay.
Get your hands dirty, sir.
And this one here, the bags have been changing sizes over the years, so you want about half to three quarters of a bag, not the whole thing. So grab the bottom, so don't put the whole thing in there. Okay. And this is just for the moisture content of the stuffing itself. What you're going to do, you have your couple of cans of chicken broth. So I'm going to open these for you, Taylor, and just throw them in there.
The
just pour it in there. What you're going to be doing is you're going to be soaking them.
That's my Julia Child.
Taylor likes to sing like that.
It's the spatula. Okay. So dump it in there. There's that one there. I'm going to have to pull the whole lid off of here. Well, you can.
There we go. There we go.
Strong.
Thank you.
Strong cans.
This one should come out a little bit quicker. Watch this one here. Just dump it all in there.
Okay,
so you're soaking the croutons. I'll mix them up so you get the liquid all throughout there. Now, while this is soaking, you're going to
get in there, Taylor. Come on.
Take your whole pound of pork sausage, your sage-flavored pork sausage. You're going to brown it up.
Okay.
So that's really good. So we got that all browned up. Taylor came in early and did that as well. So we thank you for that.
I know, right?
Now, as this was done in the pan, you can see it's cooking right now. Mm-hmm. Jackie's been sauteing a large onion in the full stick of butter.
Oh, you're welcome, America.
It is a full stick of butter, a quarter pound of butter. So you have all that. Now we need a little bit of garlic to go in there. Now, the garlic, you can either do the fresh one if you want or use the jar. It's a lot easier. Remember, a half a teaspoon is equivalent to a clove of garlic. So you're going to take a clove of garlic.
Okay.
We're going to reach over. We're going to put a clove of garlic in there. So it's just that simple.
Okay.
So you are good with that one. Now, you're going to stir that up a little bit.
Got lots of smells going on here right now.
Oh, there's tons of smells going on here.
Does it smell good? Yeah.
Now, it's a real simple process of just combining the different things. Now, how about the sausage? We'll take the sausage and put it in.
Is that me?
Yep.
Okay.
We'll put the sausage in with that
sausage.
Whole mixture. Now, we mentioned that we have
How long do I stir?
Just until we tell you to stop.
Okay. Well, I'm going to get a cramp.
So that's going to go in there. Now, you're heating this up. Now,
I'm cramping.
Okay, that's good. You're just going to let it soak. You're good. I don't want you to cramp up. But now, while these are soaking, you're heating this up. Now, one of the things about this is you're going to see that a lot of these items, they are going to be getting heated, so it's not going to take that long in the oven if you put it in the oven right afterwards.
Got
now, people were making this last week and put it in the refrigerator. It'll take about an extra half an hour if you put it in the refrigerator time-wise for heating it up, but we'll give you those details. Now, you saw that we have an entire stock
of celery, and you chop it up. Use your mandolin. Your mandolin is your best friend on things like this. Look at how uniform this is, and remember the uniformness of the little pieces make it cook a lot easier and make it cook a lot more even across the board. So you take this, and it sounds like a lot, but it's going to give it a really nice crunch.
Okay.
So you have a whole stick of celery, Jackie. You're putting in the pan that you're sautéing the onions and the garlic and the sausage. So
getting
those go
in there.
Now you're going to want to let this cook down just a little bit. We're not going to cook it down this morning, but we're going to let this cook down for about a good 10 minutes or so, just to get it's a touch softness on the celery pieces.
Okay.
So that is pretty cool. So you have that. That is really good. Now, here's something you might not have thought of. Water chestnuts in stuffing. It gives it a real distinct crunch.
Okay.
Have you had water chestnuts before?
Once in my life.
Try one.
All right, once in your life?
Try a water chestnut.
I love it.
Now that crunchiness is going to stay.
I like it.
It's going to pick up the flavors of the stuffing. The water chestnuts, again, it's a whole little canister of these, and these are on sale too. So you have these. Now we're going to add this to
the
mixture. All
right, throw them in.
So we're going to put that in there.
All righty.
So Jackie has that going, which
very
is
crunchy.
Nice. Now we have a little bit of pepper that is going to go along with that as well.
Oops.
So if you have
I'm
your pepper,
cook.
So we already have it. Actually, I forgot I have it here. I have my little old-fashioned.
When did you get that thing?
At the fair.
Oh, okay.
It's one of the original ones too, but it's already pre-measured on top, so we'll put a little pepper in there.
Pepper. A little zhuzh.
Whatever you like.
A little zhuzh.
Okay, whatever you like when it
look
comes
how
to
good
pepper.
That's looking.
Now, here is a tricky part. Taylor, we'll see how good you are
at
cracking eggs open because we need some eggs. We have the little whisk here. We need a couple of eggs. Put them right in this little
in the jar.
In this little measuring cup. Okay. Here's what this is called.
Very good.
All right, there you go. So crack on a flat surface.
In case you didn't know.
I'll make it easier. On a flat surface, and then you can open it up. And
see if you can do it with one hand.
With one hand?
Yeah.
I don't think so. It's in.
Woo!
There you go. There's one. There's
one.
Two. Two eggs. Did you just...
I'm fired.
Hang on.
Taylor Caduce, you are fired.
It's a clean counter. We cleaned the counter, thankfully, before it
from
started.
From Lou's Mom Stuffing's recipes, you are
I'm so sorry.
Kill off the germ, so don't worry
I'm
about
so
it.
I'm so sorry.
There you go.
Okay,
boom.
Here you go. There you are. Whisk it up. That makes it even more authentic, because don't tell me you haven't done that at
my
home,
wife
everybody.
Does the cooking at
See,
home.
See, this
yeah.
is all part of all the magic
it's all,
that's
the
going
reality
on
is all coming out. Okay.
So you have that. Now, Jackie, you have the rice that was cooked already, right?
We got the rice.
Okay, you're going to get the rice.
The rice
is getting ready to go. That'll be coming up in one more step. We're going to take the eggs.
Am I putting this in here?
Yep, you will in a second. First, to take the eggs, throw the eggs in the mixture, in the hot mixture.
Seriously, I'm fired. Like, oh my gosh.
You're doing good, Taylor.
Thanks.
Okay.
We're gonna invite you over here to cook more often.
All right. Now, you take the wild rice that's already been cooked.
Okay.
And dump that all in there.
Dumping.
Okay. And that creates the majority of the flavor that goes into this mixture. So you're gonna thoroughly mix that. She's gonna get that going in here. And as I said, you want it to cook down for a little bit, maybe 5-10 minutes, just to get the celery. It's a little softer than its original state.
Okay.
Okay, but don't overdo it.
Did you know that some people call stuffing dressing?
Mm-hmm. We don't.
Sorry, throw that out there.
Just in case you wanted to know, fun fact.
I just learned that yesterday.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't know that.
That's a new
whatever you
want to
call it. Whatever you want to call it.
We call it,
you'll be good.
Yum.
Now, here is another part that is important.
Okay,
here's the croutons that were soaked in the chicken broth.
Right?
Okay.
So Taylor did that.
They're not smushed. You don't want to smush these.
I didn't ruin those.
No. Okay.
You did not ruin them.
What you're going to do now is take this mixture that's on the
stove. Okay, Taylor.
Okay.
You're the strong one here.
Okay. And I'll hold the pan for you. How about this? And I'll let you scoop it out here.
Here you go,
Taylor.
You're
going to scoop it in there.
Scoop, scoop.
Scoop.
Okay, a little bit of it. Now that's it. Now you want to start mixing it, but you want to fold it. So reach underneath the bottom of the croutons and fold it.
So.
You don't want to smash them up. You want to keep the croutons so they're still cubes like
you're
that.
You're doing good.
Oh my gosh.
There's the rest of it in there.
I'm a pro.
Okay.
All right, getting it all folded in.
Okay.
And then?
You take a pan. You don't put it in the turkey.
Okay.
You take it, you put it in a pan, folks. And you just dump it
all in.
Okay.
We like it when we can just corn dump and ready to go.
And then cover it with foil, stick it in the oven, 350. Now, since this stuff here has already been cooked for the most part, about 45 minutes to an hour, use a thermometer, make sure you get it up to temperature, and you'll be good. And through the magic of TV, Jackie.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, we have some created here. And I know, Taylor, you haven't had this before.
Yeah, let's get right to it.
Reach over here.
Here we go.
Ta-da. Swap them out. Here is the completed stuffing, and this is what it looks like, ladies and gentlemen. And when it comes to spoons and everything, I have those in here.
Okay.
Let's get you a fork, I should say.
Yes, please.
And let you give it a taste test.
Yeah,
this
happy to.
Lou's Mom
this
Stuffing.
Is the part I'm
now,
good
the recipe
first
is
time
online.
Ever.
It's on our Facebook page. If you go there, you can see Taylor create this masterpiece. And take it.
Good?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. How about that, folks?
Very
this
good.
Is an amazing concoction that my mom made years ago in honor of her. Have it at your Thanksgiving dinner
and
celebrate. And you did it.
All right. Good job, Taylor Canoes.
That's Lou's the last
mom
time I'm doing that, folks.
We'll be right back. This is CW Iowa Live. I need a fork.